Graduating Catamounts, faculty, staff, and esteemed family and friends, please join me in welcoming Ms. Mary Hill Lewis to the podium.
Good morning, faculty, family, and friends. Thank you for being here to share this day with us. I was once lovingly told that it's a great surprise I didn't turn out dumber than a box of rocks. Today, I would like to share the journey of how I, Mary Lewis, defeated all odds and persevered to stand to speak with you today as part of the graduating class of 2019. To my peers, as you sit anxiously awaiting your degree today, I ask you to envision with me just a moment our futures. Our futures beyond the tassels, the funny hats, and the sea of purple present here today. For in this exact moment, a dream is being realized for me and each of you. Take it in and be proud of all that you have achieved. Thank you for sharing this moment and allowing me to speak to you. Thank you to my family and supporters. They have helped me find the courage, the strength, and the ability to stand here with each of you today. I am filled with gratitude as I am in awe of the mercy and success that has been granted to me. One of my papa's favorite sayings as he surveyed his family and home was, "I have to drink from the saucer as my cup runneth over." Today, surrounded by all of you, my cup runneth over. As I share my story today, I hope that each of you can reflect on your own story and those that have inspired you to search for the power within yourself to achieve your goals. At a very young age, I had to learn to fight for what many others my age took for granted, mere survival. My father passed away suddenly when I was 3, and my birth mother was never able to recuperate mentally from the loss of her spouse. My childhood was filled with struggles. Simple necessities such as food and education were out of my reach. Childhood was not a safe harbor as drugs and alcoholism ruled the life of my mother. In the years after my father's death, home was not a warm and welcoming place. My mother remarried several times, each time adding additional siblings. Siblings that would rely on me for care, although I was under the age of 10. I often found myself as a young child protecting 3 younger siblings and fighting for our survival as our mother continued on a downward spiral. Survival was top priority in my formative years. For 10 years after my father's death, I lived between foster homes and the unstable home of my biological mother. It would seem that my mother's story would become my own, that history would repeat itself. But there was a definitive moment in my life when at the age of 13, I was blessed beyond measure to find my forever home. A stable home that provided love and the necessities of a hot meal, a safe and warm place to sleep so that education could become a top priority in my life. And yes, even the occasional discipline came with this home. It was in this home that I was gifted a new chance at success. All I had to do was reach out and take control of my own destiny by letting go of the angry, rebellious persona I had carried for so many years. It took years of emotional support and love from this family for me to accept that I was actually part of a real family. With the encouragement and support of my family, I became the first in my maternal biological family to ever graduate high school. Soon after my graduation, I married and moved away from home. I became a mother at the age of 21, one of the proudest moments of my life. I poured heart and soul into raising my daughter for 18 years. Life was difficult at times during these years as I went through a divorce and the struggles of single parenting, but I had an unconditional love for my daughter that always carried us through. My daughter graduated high school with honors when I was 39 years old. I had broken the cycle of foster care for my daughter. As she moved to Raleigh to attend college, an empty nest reminded me once again that after 18 years of motherhood, I needed to find a venue to improve my own perception of myself. For 39 years, I fought to find some validity to my existence, struggled with feelings of depression, and was void of self-esteem. I often worked 2 or 3 jobs at once with no feeling of reward. I spent all these years searching for something that would make me proud of myself. I had no idea that what I was seeking could be found in higher education. I began to pursue an associate degree at a local community college at the same time my daughter started college. I realized in a short time after beginning, this was the challenge I needed. My heart and mind were ready for higher education as a lifetime of struggle had molded me into a warrior. Today, higher education has made me proud of myself, has allowed me to feel that I am just as important as all those around me, and I can honestly say has healed my heart of childhood traumas. Advocating for young children is my passion in life, as every child deserves a voice. I will accept every opportunity to speak up for a child with passion, as no child should ever have to experience the heartache I had to overcome. My education will provide opportunities that will never be in the realm of my possibilities. In addition to working full-time as a child care director, I am a mother, a nanny, a daughter, and a wife. I have completed 3 degrees, 2 associate degrees, and today my bachelor's degree in less than 6 years. Thank you. I do not say this to you to brag, but to encourage you to reach deep inside and find the power to believe in yourself and achieve your goals. Today is not the end of my journey. My education will continue, as Dr. Mary sounds perfect. In my 3 years as a catamount, I have achieved a variety of accomplishments. My resume looks superb thanks to the education I have received from the support of my professors. To Jennifer Bosworth, Western Alumni and Department Chair of Early Education at AB Tech, I say thank you. Thank you for being there from the beginning. To Dr. Caitlin Bargreen, thank you for your support and guidance. I will never forget your words of encouragement when I often felt this last semester was going to be impossible. You kept pushing and encouraging, and here we are. Now, as I continue on my journey, I will remember the reality of my childhood as the foundation of the person I am today. Yet it is only chapter 1 of my memoirs, a true success story, a story that I hope to share one day in a book entitled Dumber Than a Box of Rocks, But Always Striving for More. You may wonder why this phrase is mentioned again and why it has such a profound meaning to me. These words were shared with me at an old kitchen table by a man that believed in me, a man that loved me as a daughter. He was a man of few words, but when he spoke, we all listened. The night before he passed away, he told me that he always expected I would grow up dumb as a box of rocks. Then he flashed me that famous grin and laugh, and he said, "Nah, I take that back, sis. You're gonna be okay." This was his way of telling me he was proud. Melanie Beatty, an author of self-help books and recovery specialist, states, "Gratitude unlocks the fullness of life. It turns what we have into enough and more. It turns denial into acceptance, chaos to order, confusion to clarity. It can turn a meal into a feast, a house into a home, and a stranger into a friend." These words summarize my experience from Western Carolina University. My doubts have been transformed into success. My denial of believing I'm capable of succeeding in life has now turned into acceptance of all that I am and all that I will continue to be. Western Carolina University has taught me to live in the moment, to take the vacation, to cheer extra loud with my fellow catamounts at the football games, regardless of the score, because this has become my nation. Class of 2019, I ask you today to pledge with me to continue to share life experiences, to continue to seek out listening opportunities, to yearn for additional knowledge, and be grateful for the determination instilled in us to complete our task today. I encourage you to mold your heart into a warrior and be your own best advocate. Take time to listen to those around you. Be slow to speak. Savor the experiences of those who have stood exactly where you are at this moment. Cherish your individuality as you prepare yourself to take your next journey. Let all of us reminisce how our hearts feel today as we forever leave our paw mark on Cullowhee, as we call Western Carolina University home. Today I leave you with these thoughts. Never grow weary of working toward unity. Never grow weary of reaching for success. Never grow weary of doing good for each other. And above all, never grow weary of loving unconditionally. Congratulations to class of 2019, and go Cats!